Can you speak slowly and high, please, Andrew?
Okay. Undoubtedly, the practice of craft magic, whatever, is very powerful. How advisable do you think it is for anybody suffering a mental illness or going through a second stage of depression or anything like that to actually practice craft or do mental work?
Oh, you're coming on to a controversial subject. I'm quite fortunate and suffer sadness. Fortunate I don't suffer from depression. I do know that magical practices can take me to a place that is painful, but it's also a place of self-discovery. So when people come and ask for initiation, I think it's wise to ask them, do you suffer from depression? Most of them tell you the truth, and I have initiated people who have psychological illnesses that need medication. And I believe that initiating those people is a mistake. I actually believe that when people come for initiation, I have to say, I have a responsibility to my covens there and to my witches, brothers and sisters that I work with. And when you take a person who is mentally disturbed, they can upset the ritual. They can destroy it. And we find you as a copper are becoming psychiatric doctors and nurses, and even worse, it becomes a counseling session. I didn't come into Whitgrove to experience a mental hospital. I did a lot of training in the mental hospital, so I've experienced it on board. I thoroughly enjoyed every moment, even though some of it was quite frightening. I've also seen that in a circle, and I've seen the totally sane go insane. So, no, and yes. I think I love that I see the danger, so I don't think I want to do it again. And I don't want to put my coven at risk, nor that person at risk. I have a responsibility, and that responsibility is magic that my coven work. Please disagree with me.